Yes, it's just a man on a hill, but that they'd even let us film that was pretty remarkable. Hezbollah, the most secretive of militants that the US government still lists as a terrorist organization, taking journalists on a victory lap. They say they've routed hundreds of al-Qaeda-linked Syrian militants, the Nusra Front, a terrorist group to the US. From these, the ungovernable mountains that divide their peaceful home in Lebanon from where they're fighting with the Syrian regime inside Syria. Shots, perhaps, at distant enemies, or maybe for cameras who've been told strictly no faces, no voices, no phones. They've cleared about 200 square miles, mostly in Syria, they say. Nearly half still ahead, toughest in the distance here, the Lebanese town of Arsal. This was the fight recently, and it's a complex security operation that they insist is vital for Lebanon's safety. Critics say they risk starting a wider fire in Lebanon, though, to help the Syrian regime. Yet the tour takes an unexpected turn to cross the border into Syria.
Well, Hezbollah have been in a grueling fight inside Syria for years, but here they're keen to show us that they consider themselves the victor, taking this tour of some Western media inside Syrian territory. We're just across the border here, but 10 kilometers of deserted mountains they say they've cleaned out of Nusra Front rebels are there until you reach the Syrian military.
Yet more surprises. Here's the remnants of who they routed and the shoulder-launched missiles they say they had. Nusra Front fighters, we're told, linked to al-Qaeda, but once scratching out a life in caves lit by generators. We hear a rumbling around the corner, and here it might be Syrian army tanks. We move on. So will this offensive, and perhaps Hezbollah's bid, to bring themselves out of the shadows. Nick Paton Walsh, CNN, on the Syrian-Lebanese border.